I'm joined on the line by Gerard Deer. Gerard, good morning.
Good morning, Tommy.
Gerard, you work in Endokenny's constituency office in Tucker Street in Castlebar. You were in the Welcoming Hotel at Castlebar yesterday when Taoiseach Endokenny visited there. Stephen Kerr said that he was physically manhandled and he was dragged out of the crowded room.
No, absolutely not true, Tommy. And I think it's very disingenuous, the posting he is up on the YouTube, that the Taoiseach ignored the link between fluoride and depression. The Taoiseach was there to launch a very, very important document, probably one of the most important, significant documents ever launched in this county regarding mental health with young people throughout the county. There was over 300 or 400 people there, a lot of young people, and the Taoiseach was very engaged with the crowd. He's a huge interest in this whole topic.
Has Stephen Kerr.
Yes, absolutely. And regarding Stephen, I know Stephen quite well, and he's been in his office several times, and the Taoiseach has engaged with a lot of people regarding that, and he's well aware of that situation. Yesterday, he had a very, very tight schedule. He had to be in Mulroney in the evening, and Stephen was there when the Taoiseach, at the end of the day, as he was leaving, there was a number of photos that had been arranged with some of the schools around the county. Stephen was up with a camera right in the Taoiseach's face. He said he wanted to interview the Taoiseach, talk to him. I said, Stephen, Taoiseach has a very tight schedule. He can't do it. And he said, I'm entitled to do it. I said, Stephen, you can't. Taoiseach has a schedule, and he was late already for the thing in Mulroney, and he had a prior commitment with some of the other young schools there, people from the schools. So I beckoned to the member of the security staff, the Garda Síochána, just to tell Stephen he couldn't. And the guard went over to him and escorted him just to the side and said, explained that Taoiseach was running a very tight schedule. So there was no manhandling of anyone. And look at the video.
Escorted is different to physical manhandling, I imagine.
Absolutely. And look, the Taoiseach is the most accessible Taoiseach in the history of the state. He engages with people. He walks to work every morning. He meets people, talks to them, and there's no better person than the Taoiseach to engage with people. But yesterday wasn't the time or the place for that. There's a protocol in place and there's a procedure in place. If Stephen wanted to meet the Taoiseach, we'd certainly arrange it. There's no problem with that. So it's very disingenuous to put that posting up on the thing. He did not ignore him.
All right, fair enough, point made. But was he asked to leave the room? Was he dragged out of a crowded room?
No, not. He was escorted to the side to let the Taoiseach through.
All right.
Thanks.
Solved. Stephen Kerr, I was going to say Stephen Kerr, thank you, but this is Gerard Deer, thank you.
Thanks for
By the way, a lot of listeners are just asking, does Endokenny still have clinics?
Yes, he does indeed, but naturally his schedule is very tight,
yes.
And there's a waiting list for people to meet him, but he does clinics, yeah.
Well, there's an email just popped into you now from Stephen Kerr to say thanks.
Okay.
All right, listen,
thank
good luck.
You.
That's Gerard Deer on the line. Thanks, Ger, for that. Just before I go, I want to...